Hey, it's David Elder, and today on Texas Eats, we're traveling all across the Lone Star State, going to great restaurants you won't want to miss.
Get ready for the Texas vs. Memphis barbecue competition with Smoke Shack as they show us their pork and dessert options that they're going to be serving up at the event. Plus, we get scratch-made dumplings, noodle bowls, and more at a new restaurant in Austin. And we check out a spot with Smashburgers, cocktails, loaded fries, and more in San Antonio. All that and more right now on Texas Eats.
We're back out here at the Smoke Shack north of downtown San Antonio to go talk with owner Chris Conger to see what he's going to be serving up for his pork and dessert options at this year's Texas vs. Memphis barbecue competition happening November 2nd at the Alamo Dome for the UTSA vs. Memphis football game. Let's go inside and check it out. Joining us now is Chris Conger, and Chris, right in front of us, you have your pork option that's going to be available at the event. So what's the name of it, and what's it all about?
We've got the hog log. It's a pork tenderloin stuffed with cream cheese and jalapenos.
So what's the first thing you do to prep this out?
We're going to butterfly this pork tenderloin first. Just right down the middle, super easy cut. Inside and out, we got Meat Church's honey hog. It's got a little bit of a sweetness to it. Now that the pork's prepped, we're gonna go with the cream cheese filling.
When you're doing this, it's easier to kind of make the shape because this cream cheese is a little tough, right?
It's a little tough, yeah.
It's like making sushi, you know?
Yeah. So now that we got our cream cheese and jalapeno stuffing, we're gonna just wrap this up, set it aside, and then we're gonna lay out our bacon. Now,
so you have 7 pieces of bacon right there. You're rolling this bad boy up. Look at that.
Bam.
A little more seasoning on the outside.
I'm gonna throw this in the smoker for about an hour and a half, 250, 275. And then once we bring it off, then we're gonna brush it with that Brush Fire Farms glaze.
Now we have a sweet treat in front of us. It's time for that sweet bite that you're gonna be serving up at the event. So what's going on with this one?
Yeah, so this is a really simple dish. We got mascarpone, we got cream cheese, we've got this prickly pear syrup, and we're gonna top it off with a little lime zest.
And then, so you have these little cups. What are the cups made out of?
Yeah, that's just phyllo dough. You can go buy it at the grocery store.
You have some whipped cream that you made here in-house.
Yep.
And I'm just gonna kind of, bam.
Bam.
What do you think? That was a...
That's perfect.
That was hefty.
Top it off with some lime zest.
Oh, beautiful.
We are just gonna go right on top.
Ooh.
Just to give it a little color.
Chris, this looks amazing. That's artwork.
And I'm not even a dessert guy.
Now you are.
Yeah.
Look at this.
It's pretty good.
You've been motivated by the event to now have, you gotta serve this at the restaurant. The hog log is out of the smoker. It's over here on the cutting board. So now you're going, oh, look how beautiful that is slicing into it. And you finish it off here with this one. Now this is the Brush Fire Farms. This is the original glaze. So what are the flavor profiles of this?
So it started out, it's like a chili piquin. So we try and use as much South Texas as we can in our products. Started out chili piquin. It's a really good, just, I mean, for ribs, for pork, chicken.
So where can you find these at for people that want to get these sauces?
Yeah, well, actually, just right down the road at Central Market, have almost all of our products.
All right, going for the pork first here, the hog log. Beautiful piece, look at that. That looks absolutely delicious. Cheers to you.
Cheers.
Oh, that's the ultimate bite. Oh my goodness, so tender, packed full of flavor. The cream cheese brings so much, it's like a balance to everything. Kind of neutralizes some of the sweetness that you have on there too, so you get a really good flavor profile. The bacon is on point. On to the dessert, the prickly pear. What would you call this, like a tart? What do you call
yeah.
this?
Yeah, I mean,
cheers.
Sure, whatever.
Syrup is really, really nice. The lime coming in and adding that punch of citrus on there, it's vibrant, great texture, and then that little cup on the outside is a great crunch. That's a really good bite. Great job.
Thank you.
I'm excited. I'm gonna eat a bunch more of this.
Y'all come vote for us, come on.
On November 2nd, 2024, he and his team will represent Texas in a showdown of smoke and flavor at the Alamo Dome, where there'll be a barbecue competition during the UTSA versus Memphis game, going head-to-head with Corky's Barbecue from Memphis.
Hey, San Antonio, I'll see y'all on November 2nd at the Alamo Dome.
Today on A Taste of Texas with Shiner Bach Beer, we're at Casa Katrina on the Riverwalk in San Antonio. This Dia de Muertos themed bar with great bites has murals, and they also have statues depicting the different Katrines and Katrinas all over the building. There's a bar downstairs. There's an upstairs area as well that you can sit and eat and drink. And there's so many great bites, all these different salsas made in-house, and these tacos are top tier. I love the tortillas on there. Wash it all down with an ice-cold Shiner beer. It's the perfect time of year to go in there and check it out. Follow Casa Katrina on social media for upcoming events and drink specials.
Now we're here in Austin at the Triangle to go inside of a new restaurant that's serving up a variety of dumplings, noodle bowls, and so much more. Let's see what's on the menu at Dumpling World. Joining us now is one of the owners out here at the restaurant, Shu. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you for coming.
Now, Dumpling World, it is what it sounds like. It's dumplings, and you get to come out here to the restaurant, and you get to try a lot of different kinds of dumplings.
Yes.
And this first step to make the dumplings is right here in front of us.
This is actually a mixer to make the dough. And we wrap it and bring it to the outside. That's the dumpling station.
We can see it's getting rolled out. And so there's two different kinds of dumplings being made right in front of us. Kind of like what you would be familiar with, like a pot sticker, like we would say, like, right? But
exactly.
Then that style over there, it actually is like more of the traditional, like a dumpling shape.
When they finish like dumplings here, they send it to the freezer.
Dumplings!
Yeah.
All right, now we got to go to the kitchen and see how they get cooked up.
It's right there. It's a steam machine, and we steam soup dumplings, steam dumpling right there. And for this one right here, it's a pot sticker machine.
Ooh.
So it's gonna make pot stickers and a pan fried thumb bomb.
You got it all. You got a little bit of everything.
Yes.
Now we're gonna go out to the front, to the dining room.
Okay.
Because now we've seen the process. This is the final step over here, and we're gonna go try a little bit of the top items on the menu.
Okay.
I'm super excited.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go. So this one is a colorful dumpling, and for the green one, bok choy and a mushroom. Yellow one, that's a chicken and corn. And for the red one, it's a pork chive and shrimp.
Oh man, all right, I'm going for the red one. You sold me on that one, cheers. So much flavor in there. It's cool that you have different options for different people, depending on their palate or what their dietary restrictions are.
Yeah. That one is a pork and the sticky rice shumai. It's very different.
Okay, we gotta go for this one. Here you go,
yes.
Cheers.
Very different, right?
Very different. You could taste each one of the rice that's in there, and then the pork has a good little bite to it as well. Great flavor. And I like that you don't have to dunk these in anything.
No. That's why we just have a very simple stuff on the table. It's like soy sauce, vinegar, but I don't think many people use them because the dumpling itself is very flavorful.
Yeah.
This is the pork soup dumpling.
How do you like to eat yours?
I take a small bite, then I sip it.
Oh, you sip it. That's a different experience. It's like you're kissing the dumpling. Finish some love on that one.
Well, for soup, we'll do the soup first, then dumpling second.
But I gotta say, the soup dumpling
is best seller here.
It's so good. I mean, that's the one I'd go for every day of the week. Right next to it, you have another little batch right here. What's going on with this one?
Spicy wonton.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you meant spicy.
This is, yeah, it's kind of.
All right, here we go. Woo! That's pretty spicy.
Yeah.
Wow. So sure you like spice. That's really good.
This is the spicy tofu pot sticker. This is a very unique recipe we have here.
Okay, let's go for it. Cheers.
Mm-hmm. Something different, right?
That was very different, but that was really good. I'm not usually looking for tofu on the menu, but I tell you what, you could change my mind on that one. That is really nice and not too spicy.
And this is actually the hardest dumpling that we can make here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it takes
time.
That's
not
too bad. It takes
time. I tell you what, Dumpling World, it is exactly that. It is a world of dumplings out here, and there's something here for everyone. You have a vegetarian option, you have the pork, you have the chicken, you have tofu on the menu as well. Spicy, not spicy, you have noodles. It's a great spot. Since we've been here for lunch, it's just been in and out, people loading up the place. It's a really cool place. So come on out to Austin, visit the Triangle, see Dumpling World, and more locations coming soon, right?
Yes.
All right, I'm gonna go for one of these drinks in the back right here. Which one is this one?
Ubetaro.
All right, I gotta have another dumpling.
Coming up later on Texas Eats, experience rich flavors of the Mediterranean at this new Italian joint in San Antonio. And next on the show, we check out a spot with Smashburgers, cocktails, loaded fries, and more in San Antonio. Texas Eats will be right back after the break. Welcome back to Texas Eats. Now we're here off East Grayson Street, just outside the Pearl, north of downtown San Antonio, to check out a new Smashburger spot that's serving up some classic bites, plus some spins on some old favorites. Let's see what's on the menu at Smash. Joining us now is the owner out here at the restaurant, Aaron Tyerman. Thank you so much for having us.
Well, thank you for coming.
Now, you guys have made everything on the menu that's hidden. These are the number one top items, including cocktails. Talk to me about the concept, though. How did this get started?
It grew out of inspiration from Chef Brandon Peterson, which I think most of you know from summer camp and from Bandit Barbecue. And so what we did was we took his famous smash burger and expanded it.
This one right here is like the base smash burger, right? This is like your standard classic. You call it the OG.
American cheese, homemade pickles, mustard, our smash sauce, and the brioche bun.
That is good. This thing is nuts. Talk to me about this one.
It is a carne asada. We have cheddar cheese, sour cream. It's got french fries and guacamole inside.
Are you a spicy salsa person? You're going to go for it? Okay, go for the spicy salsa. I like it.
Give it some elbow.
Bam.
That is good.
All right, we got a chicken sandwich in the front. What's going on with this one?
So this is our buffalo chicken smash. So what this is it's buffalo sauce, pepper jack cheese, our homemade pickles, a blue cheese dressing, and a creamy ranch slaw.
Just the bread and that slaw sauce all day, every day. We have a full cocktail menu that actually comes out here with the regular menu.
So that's our classic smash. So it is a play on a whiskey smash. So it's Basil Hayden bourbon, lemon juice, maple syrup, some bitters.
A little sweet, nice, and kind of smoky almost. That's really good. You also have asada fries loaded up in the back. So we're going to get a bite of that. And then we're going to head into the kitchen. Now, what are we making?
You are about to make this lovely little wake and bacon burger right here. This is one of our best sellers.
All right, cheers.
Cheers.
Now we're in the kitchen with Chef Brandon Peterson. Chef, thank you so much for having us in your kitchen, man.
Absolutely, welcome.
Now you're going to be showing us, it's a wake and bacon burger. What's the first thing you do to make it?
First thing we do is we're going to toast the brioche bun. So we're using Texas Wagyu beef now. And it's right there in the name, so we got to throw down some bacon.
That's the easiest I've ever seen anybody do that. And I've seen a lot of smash burgers.
Very strong.
You're right. Yeah. Got the hash brown chilling. I'm just gonna grab it. No.
Very hot. I've done it. Okay, so this is a roasted jalapeno aioli that we make in-house.
Crispy bacon, hash brown. You got the egg chilling, fresh pickles. Guys, smash right here off Grayson. Amazing spot to come get smash burgers. You get great cocktails. You can also get the burritos. Lots of options. Even this one right here, the wake and bacon burger. That's the bite. This is incredible. Y'all, this is the one to get. Coming up next on Texas Eats. Experience rich flavors of the Mediterranean at this new Italian joint in San Antonio. Texas Eats will be right back after the break. Welcome back to Texas Eats. Now we're here on the northwest side of San Antonio to go inside of a new restaurant that's serving up Italian-inspired dishes. Plus, they got desserts, and we're gonna go in the kitchen to see how it's made. Let's see what's on the menu at Mari Monte. Joining us now is the owner out here at the restaurant, Prince Vyakash. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much for coming in.
Now, I'll tell you what, it's gorgeous in here. The ambiance is perfect. You've set such a beautiful tone in here. And then the food, it smells incredible. It looks over the top. So I got to know, why restaurants? How did you get started in this?
Man, I came in America 6 years ago. I used to be a doctor of physical therapy. They didn't let me be a doctor over here. So I started to work in an Italian restaurant. I was crazy enough to fall in love with that. So here I am 6 years after, man.
Why Italian food?
I think it's the best food in the world. This is a calamari arrabbiata. So we bred the calamari. I learned it in Venice how to do this. Then we put some marinara, a little bit of garlic, salt, pepper, and cherry peppers. That gives the Texas on the calamari. A little bit spicy. But I put a star in this dish because I like it a lot.
Ooh. Ooh. I'm gonna go for another one.
I love this.
Oh my gosh. I would just order that plate right there. Now we're getting into the heavy hitters. These are some of the entree items that you can order. We'll start with the fish in the front.
Yes, this is a lemon sole arrabbiata style. So it's the same way like the shrimp. We put breadcrumbs on top and we serve it with a spinach and asparagus risotto.
The fish just melts in your mouth.
Yes.
And this pasta, it's a black pasta, right?
It's a fresh pasta. We make it with cherry peppers, a little bit of scallions, a little bit of garlic, a little bit of pancetta, and all finished with some chopped shrimp in there. It's Texas Gulf shrimp, beautiful.
Wow.
You make me too happy.
Right in the back, you have lamb chops.
Yes.
Come on, I love lamb chops.
Lamb chops we cook very, very simple, like salt, pepper, rosemary. And we serve it with garlic spinach and garlic mashed potatoes.
All right, lamb chops, that's the bite. Chef Lorik, he's doing incredible things back
he
there.
Does.
We're also gonna go into the kitchen right now. Yes. You're gonna show us how to make one of these dishes from start to finish. What are we gonna make?
We're gonna make the Bronx chicken parmigiana.
All right, Prince, now we're in the kitchen and you're gonna show us how you make the Bronx chicken parmesan from start to finish. What's the first thing you do?
We have some chicken over here. Our chicken is very small. We put it on flour a little bit just to make the egg stick. So we're gonna egg it up a little bit over here. Then we put it on our special breading and we're gonna pan fry it.
Okay, you have the noodles right here, right?
We have the noodles. They are fresh fettuccine, very nice. We're gonna cook them in the water over there. So we're gonna prepare the Alfredo sauce in here.
Ooh, okay.
Right, this is Alfredo.
So you have your base Alfredo. It's already made.
Base Alfredo. Yep. It's already made. Just adding some vodka sauce in here.
So the cherry pepper is something you're adding in to make it that extra Texas, right?
Texas twist.
Lots of mozzarella, right? Let's go.
This is the peppers, this is the cheese, everything. Just finished it with some Parmigiano Reggiano.
Mary Monte, this restaurant is so beautiful on the inside. The family vibe that you get, the food is exceptional. The whole team out here is incredible. Prince, thank you so much for having us.
I'm proud of everybody in here.
Cheers to you, the Brooklyn Chicken Parmesan. That's incredible. Thank you for watching today's episode of Texas Eats. And to get more information and a map on all the restaurants that you've seen on today's show, just go to our website, texaseatstv.com. Don't forget to follow us on social media at Texas Eats TV. And don't forget to join us every Saturday at 10 o'clock in the morning and 11 o'clock at night right here on KSAT 12, because this is how Texas Eats.